guys, it's Jade Alexis and I'm back with another video for y'all today on my channel. I think that's what I'm gonna start saying now when I do new videos, because I be seeing people have these, you know, little sayings that they say when they start videos and I don't have one. So I think I'm gonna start saying that. So let me know if y'all like that. But anyway, I'm coming to you guys with this smoky brown glittery eye look with a pop of yellow in the waterline. Y'all, this look is so freaking pretty. Like, and I tried out some new products and I am giving you my first impressions in the video as well. So make sure you guys like, comment, share, subscribe. Subscribe to me and my babies couples channel, and if you guys like the video, make sure you give it a big thumbs up and let's just jump right into this tutorial. Okay, you guys, so let's get into this makeup look. Today I am going to be doing a smoky brown glittery eye for you guys, as you guys seen in the intro, and let's get started. I'm gonna be using some new products here and there, and the new products that I will be using I will tell you guys about, and I will give you guys my first impressions as I always do, and I will always be honest. So let's just get started on this eye look. Okay, so you guys know that I always start with my eyeshadow in these videos because it's just easier for me. I don't like to have to sit there and bake or put excess powder under my eyes to catch fallout because it makes my skin really, really dry. I already prepped my skin, if you guys cannot tell, but I always start off with my eyes. So today I'm gonna start with the P. Louise and Mitchell Acid Rain Collaboration Eye Primer. This is in the shade Blank Canvas, y'all. I love P. Louise's primers. Y'all should know this by now. That is like the only primer I use in my videos now. So go get you some. Okay, you guys, so here is my eyeshadow base. Today I am going to be using the Playing in Makeup by Yolanda Artistry Vault with Beauty by Melissa. If you guys do not know, Beauty by Melissa is a makeup artist from my hometown, Brooklyn, New York, and she is so excellent. Like, she is amazing. Her work is stunning, it's flawless all the time. So when she did this collaboration, I knew that I had to get it. So today I will be using this palette for this look. This is what the eyeshadows look like. Oh my god, girl, I done dipped my finger into it by accident. But this is what the palette looks like. Tell me this is not so freaking pretty, you guys. Like, this has every single color a makeup artist will ever need. This is just, oh my god, and the mirror is huge. I don't know if you guys can see it. I don't want you guys really seeing everything in our background, so I don't really want to show y'all. But guys, this palette is so pretty. It is just, I could just look at it all day. But let's get into this look. And also, this is a black owned makeup brand, and Beauty by Melissa is also a black makeup artist. So yeah, support your local black owned businesses. So to start off this eyeshadow look, I'm gonna start with the color Girl Bye, which is this dark brown shade right here. I don't know if you guys can tell how dark it really is, but I am starting with that dark brown since this is going to be a smoky brown look. It's basically just gonna be browns all over my eyes. So I'm just gonna take that Girl Bye shade and I'm just gonna start packing it onto my eyelid. Just packing it straight onto the eyelid. So you guys, my girlfriend and I are going to Vegas next month for our 2-year anniversary, and I'm so freaking excited. I know that the pandemic is still alive and well, and believe me, we are going to take the same precautions that we take here in New York when we go to Vegas. But I've always wanted to take my baby to Vegas because she's never been and I have. But when I did go, I went with like my godmom and my family. So it wasn't the same as like going with your partner or friends or whatever. So I'm actually excited to be going for a second time. And this time I'm going for a week. That last time I went, I only went for a weekend, which I feel like is really not enough time for Las Vegas because there's so much to explore. And I'm just really excited to be getting a mini vacation with everything that's going on. I know it's not really, you know, everybody's cup of tea to be going on vacation right now, but to be honest, with everything that has been going on in 2020, me and my baby really, really need it. We will also be vlogging this trip. So if you guys don't know, me and my girlfriend have a couple's channel called Jade and Jazz TV. So make sure y'all subscribe to our channel and make sure y'all show us some love, okay? Okay, next I'm gonna be going in with this shade right here called Send Nudes. Y'all, that's a cute ass name. But I'm gonna be taking a more fluffy brush and blending out that Girl Bye shade with the Send Nude shade. So y'all, this shade is actually more orange than I thought it was gonna be. I thought it was gonna be like a lighter brown, but you know, whatever mistake you make to one eye, you have to do to the second so that it'll be symmetrical. But it's all gonna turn out fine and dandy. These shades are really, really pigmented, okay? And there is not any fallout really in the pan. Like, once I tap into this shade,
tap in.
Like, you like, there's really no fallout. It's minimal, which I really appreciate. I don't know how she got it to do that and be so pigmented at the same time, because normally when you have pigmented shadows, they have fallout, but not these good. Not these good. So as you guys can see, I did not blend out the shades really. I kind of just tapped them all on and then blend it out later, and you guys will see how I do that. So this is what the eyes are looking like so far, and now I'm gonna blend those two shades together. Okay you guys, so now I'm gonna be dipping into the shade So Precise, which is a bright yellow color, and that is the last color I'm gonna be taking to blend over top of that other warm brown shade and the chocolatey brown. So I'm gonna dip right into that with another blending brush, and I'm just gonna pack that over top of those two shades first before I blend everything together. Now, out of the other two shades I used, this yellow shade does have more fallout than the other two. I'm not sure why that is, but it's really pigmented, so that might be a contribution. Even though the other shades were pigmented as well, this one is just Fallout City, which I really don't mind. I expected that because I knew this palette was gonna be very pigmented from the tutorials I've seen Beauty by Melissa use her palette with. So I kind of knew that it was gonna be, you know, I thought it was gonna be a lot of fallout, which I'm surprised that the other shades didn't have fallout. But this So Precise shade definitely does have more fallout than the other two shades. Okay you guys, so this is what the eyes are looking like so far. I had to turn the brightness down a little bit because I feel like you guys really couldn't see. And now we're gonna add a little razzle dazzle to this eye to make it really pop and to make it look so sexy and beautiful and sparkly. Okay, so I am going to be adding some glitter to this look. I haven't done a glitter look in ages, so be happy. Be proud of me, because glitter really be irritating me sometimes because it takes forever to come off, and then it be on your face for like 5 days. So hopefully I could get it off with some tape because I've seen a method. But this glitter is by Glow Up Academy, which is another black owned makeup brand. Her name is Kiki Adams on Instagram, and she is from the New York, New Jersey area as well. I gotta support my New York beaches, my New Jersey bitches, the East Coast, we gotta rep, okay? So this is Glow Up Academy. This is in the shade Cocoa Drip. It is a chocolate glitter, y'all. ever since I ordered these glitters, I could not wait to use this one specifically. So I figured today was the motherfucking day. And also, I gotta support my black owned businesses and my bad bitches, okay? So let's get into adding this glitter to my lids. So to add the glitter, I am going to be using Duo Eyelash Glue. Y'all, this is the best stuff to stick your glitter on. I really want to show you guys this glitter, but it's like filled to the brim, which I appreciate. This is what it looks like. So this is what the glitter looks like. I'm really scared to tip it over, but it has small micro glitters. It also has real big chunky glitters. And do y'all see the reflex in those glitters? Y'all, this is about to be so popping. Duo is like the best to stick glitters on people's eyes with. So I'm just gonna spread this all over my lid. So what I'm gonna do is take my flat brush that I'm gonna apply the glitter on with, and I'm just gonna tap that eyelash glue on so that the brush gets a little tacky, and then I'm gonna dip right into the glitter. Y'all, do y'all see that? Bruh. Y'all, do y'all see this motherfucking glitter? Do y'all see this motherfucking glitter?
Oh my god! Wow!
She tried it. She tried it. Why would she ever make a glitter so beautiful? So this is what the eyes are looking like, all finished and all glittered out. So what I'm gonna do is just apply a thin black line across my top lash line. I'm not gonna really do a wing or anything like that because I want my eyes to kind of stay in this rounded shape. And I'm also gonna apply eyelashes, and I'll be right back to start the base. Okay, you guys, so here is the finished eye look. I absolutely love how this came out. I just put on some 25mm mink lashes that I got from my local beauty supply store. They look kind of weird. They look like two different eyelashes. I don't know if it's just me or when you wear your eyelashes once or twice, they start to look mad different. Like, they don't be looking the same no more after that first time you wear them. So they look a little weird, but I'm pretty sure once I do the rest of my face, it'll all come together and look fine. So I'm going to be using a new foundation today that is a matte foundation. So to prime my face, I'm going to use something that is hydrating and gripping, which is the Milk Hydro Grip. Y'all, I don't really use this often. I use this more so on my clients, not really myself. So I like it a little bit. It's not like my go-to like a lot of other people, but you know, it's pretty okay. I also took my spoolie and brushed the excess glitter off of my face, and now I'm just going to like to pump onto my face, because sometimes if I put something onto the back of my hand, I don't know, I just don't really like the back of my hands being messy. I'm just gonna take that primer and I'm gonna tap, tap, tap in, because this is like a sticky, tacky primer. So the best way to activate it, to be honest, is to tap it in so that you can get that tackiness all throughout your face. Okay, you guys, so now that I primed my face, it's time to move on to foundation. And for foundation today, we have the Too Faced Born This Way matte foundation. Excuse me, 24-hour undeductible super low wear foundation. My bad, y'all, for that belch. This is in the shade Truffle. I used to be the shade Tiramisu, but because it's the summertime and a beat got a tan, I am now the shade Truffle, and this is what it looks like. I love the normal formula, so I bought this one because in the summertime I do get really oily, and I get really oily in my T-zone mostly. So I was like, you know what, since this is summertime and I gotta buy a darker shade anyway, why not buy the matte version instead of the normal hydrating version, which I love that one. So I'm pretty sure I'm gonna love this one too, because my skin changes from season to season. I have very like weird skin. Like in the summer it's matte, in the summer it's oily, and in the winter time it's dry. So I'm gonna try this foundation out and hopefully it looks good, which it should. So let's try it out. So I'm just gonna take one pump onto my brush for now, and I'm gonna see how far that can spread me. And then we'll see. I start off more so towards the outer perimeter because I don't want to put too much product under my eyes. So I start off on the outside and work my way in, which is not normally how you're supposed to do makeup. You're supposed to start inward and go out. But I don't want to put too much makeup under my eye area because that eye area is so sensitive. So I'm also gonna get really into my nose because I have a habit of not getting makeup in this little corner right there. So I'm gonna do my face like that and tap the product into that space. So to stay in the Born This Way family, I'm gonna be using my Too Faced Born This Way Multi-Sculpting Concealers. Y'all, I really love these concealers. I usually use the shade Chestnut, but because I got a tan, this is actually a little too light, but I'm gonna mix these two shades. This is in the shade Mahogany, which they do not sell anymore, which I didn't know. They discontinued the shade Mahogany, but I got this shade in my BoxyCharm, y'all. And you know what's crazy? I was gonna buy a darker shade of this, foundation, of this concealer because of my tan, but I'm so glad I didn't because they sent it to me in my BoxyCharm. So I'm gonna use this on the outside and I'm gonna use Chestnut more towards the inside. I'm not gonna put too much because like I said, I don't wanna really look too cakey. Y'all, this foundation is like a perfect match, okay? It is like a perfect match. I'm gonna take the shade Chestnut and I'm just gonna put it all the way in the inner corner like this. And I'm just gonna bring it down. This is the shade Mahogany. As you guys can see, it's much darker and it's definitely orange. Like, I don't know if you guys can really see, but this shade is like really orange. So I'm gonna take my Real Techniques setting brush. Y'all, this brush is so good for blending out concealer. Like, it's so good for setting your eyes, obviously under your eyes too, but it's really good for blending out creams because it's almost like a dual fiber brush kind of, and it just blends into oblivion. Like, look at that blend, okay? Like, let's talk about it. So this is what my face is looking like after the concealer. I'm gonna take my foundation brush and also blend around the edges just so that I can make sure that it is seamless. I'm gonna be setting with the Fenty Beauty Pro Filter Instant Retouch Setting Powder in the shade Cashew. You guys, Jackie Ina is the one who introduced me to this shade and I just absolutely love it. I like to dip my beauty blender and then blow it off like I just did just now, which you really shouldn't do because it's kind of unsanitary. This is going on my face, I really don't care. And I just like to press this in. I don't bake at all. I just set under my eyes and press this in. And I really like this shade because it's very neutral. It's like a butter shade. It's not too light, it's not too dark, it's not like yellow, like banana. I just like it because it's just like a butter shade, like a cashew shade, like it says. Okay, you guys, so this is what I'm looking like for right now. Right here, I have a little bit of dryness. I'm not too sure why. Maybe I put a little too much powder right there. I'm pretty sure that was my fault because I do that sometimes. Like, I don't tap off enough product, so then I get a dry patch right there, but it'll all go away once I put setting spray. I know I'm looking a little mostly ghostly right now, but once I set my face, it'll all be good. I'm using the Sephora Micro Smooth Powder in the shade 60 Deep. This is what it looks like. Y'all, this powder is like one of my faves. It's very hard for me to find a powder that I like. to go all over my face, but this does exactly what it says. Micro smooth, the house down boots. I'm not sure if you really have to set this foundation because it is matte. And like, honestly, I'm not gonna lie to y'all, it's really matte. It's feeling a little drying. Now we're going to bronze so I can bring some warmth back into my skin. I'm going to be using my Hoola bronzer in the shade Toasted. Y'all, I haven't used this in ages, but this is such a really good bronzer. So I like to take a really big fluffy brush like so and swirl it around in there and get a good amount of product on there. Tap off the extra and then... Y'all, one thing about this brush, I'm not gonna lie, I really love this. This is the Morphe M527, but it really sheds like a lot, and I just washed them. So when I wash it, it shreds like even more, which I don't really understand, but whatever. So I'm just gonna take that bronzer and bronze up my face to bring back some warmth. Okay, so now I'm gonna take my Sephora Pro Face Palette in the shade Deep, and I'm gonna take this shade right here, which is the shade Epic, and I'm gonna use that to contour. I'm also gonna take a small blending brush and use that same Epic shade to contour my nose up here a little bit. I don't really wanna bring it too far down, but I'm gonna focus most of the color at the top of my nose and then drag it down a little bit, because once you contour the top of your nose, honestly, you don't really have to contour the rest of it. So for blush, I'm gonna go in with my Juvia's Place, the Saharan Blush Volume 1 palette. This is the shade I'm going in with, Toby, right here. And I'm just gonna start off on the outer portion of my cheek and bring it inward. Okay, you guys, so this is what I am looking like so far. I'm gonna take my Mario Badescu Rose Water Facial Spray and spray my face to bring some hydration back, because Lord, my face is so dry. Y'all, I really needed that much. Like, my face is so dry. So I'm just gonna apply those same eyeshadows that I put on my lid to my bottom lash line, and then I'm gonna be back to put the pop of color in and finish off this makeup look with some highlighter and some lipstick. Okay, you guys, so like I said, I put those shades that I put on my lid up under on my lower lash line. I also sprayed my face with that spray, and it made my face feel so much better and less dehydrated. Like, my face was really feeling so dry right here, and now it looks like so freaking flawless. All right, y'all, so now I'm gonna go in with my Charlotte Tilbury Airbrush Flawless Finish Powder. This is the new shade she came out with. This is in the shade 4D. And y'all, it's still not, you know, that deep, but it's deeper than the last shade she had, which was dark, and it was the shade 3. So she came out with an extra shade, which is called Tan, and now she made this shade called Deep. And now I'm finna just take this brush that I love to use, brightening under eye setting powders. I love to use this brush for that. This is the Morphe E48. So I'm just gonna dip into that like that, tap off the extra, and tap this under my eyes to give it that airbrushed finish. So what I'm gonna do is take this Fenty Beauty liner. This is the Vivid Liquid Eyeliner in Banana Blaze, and I'm gonna put that on the back of my hand, and I'm gonna try to use my brush, that same brush that I was using with the other one, to put that in my waterline. Okay, you guys, so this is what my eyes are looking like with that pop of yellow in the waterline. I actually really like how it looks. It took a little trial and error to get this pop of yellow inside of my eye because the first product I tried to use was not working out, but now I'm just gonna apply some mascara to my bottom lashes and then we'll move on to the lips and we're done. So for lips today, we're gonna be using the new MAC and Teyana Taylor collaboration. I'm gonna be using the lip pencil. This is in the shade Chestnut, which is one of my fave shades already. The lipstick is in the shade I Got a Man, and it's a matte nude shade. It's really, really pretty. The packaging on this collection is so pretty, you guys. Like, if y'all didn't get y'all hands on it, I don't know if it's still available, but she had this neon green packaging, and honey. And this is in the shade Gonna Love Me, which is one of her songs, obviously. So I'm just gonna take the liner and line our lips. This is already one of my favorite pencils, so I already know how this works. I'm gonna take the lipstick and I'm gonna apply that in the center. This shade is much more pink than I thought it was gonna be. Because this shade is so pink and light, I was gonna use the shade Gonna Love Me, which is this orange one, but I also have the lip gloss in the shade But Ain't Got No Manners, and this one is a little more darker and bronzy, so I think I'm gonna put that shade on top because I want this to get a little bit muted and I want it to be a little more nudie brownie. I don't really want it to be this pink. I'm taking that shade, But Ain't Got No Manners. Yes. So now I'm gonna take my Urban Decay All Nighter setting spray and I'm just going to spray my face. And we're done. Okay, you guys, so this is the finished product. I hope you guys really enjoyed this video. If you guys just so happen to recreate this look, which I highly doubt because I'm not that big of an influencer, but if somebody does just so happen to see this and want to recreate it, make sure y'all tag me. Make sure y'all follow me on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, Snapchat. Everything is Jada Alexis. Jada Alexis with an underscore between Jada and Alexis on Twitter and Snapchat though, okay? It's only Jada Alexis on Facebook. No, don't add me on Facebook. I don't know y'all like that. But add me on Instagram at Jade Alexis. Twitter and Snapchat is Jade underscore Alexis. A-L-E-X-Y-S. Alexis with a Y, not an I or a U. Period. And I will see you guys in the next video. I love you so much. Stay safe during everything that's happening. And remember, Black Lives Matter. And also, I don't know. All right. Love you guys. See you in the next one.